The focus, of course, for the last couple of months has been on the new racking system. We've set up some amazing aquariums and done some amazing things. However, before we start stocking, before we get too crazy, I got to admit, the 2,000 gallon has, of course, taken a back seat. Mind you, the big focus has been on the freshwater stingrays, my black diamond trio, looking to breed them. Why? I want to create an army of little stingray joey pups. However, obviously, the 2,000 gallon kind of sucks. I'll admit it. Yeah, the water's great, the fish are beautiful, but I kind of want to give them a little something, a little more enrichment to the aquarium. Now, obviously, we have a number of things to worry about, and the number one thing is, of course, the Asian arowana. Let's not put anything in the aquarium that he could hurt himself on, meaning that if he jumps, because he does, and he always does, and he will, I don't want him to land on anything. The tank is, of course, 4 feet deep. I feel like if we don't go above 2 feet, he's going to be fine. And with this, we can add in more fish, because if I have more of an aquascape within the aquarium, we can have more types of fish that are relatively a little bit smaller until they grow a little bit bigger, but they're gonna need some more refuge and places to hide. Plus, of course, we need to make this a little more aesthetically pleasing. My thoughts are this. I have massive pieces of Malaysian bogwood. I have all of these rocks. I also have a bunch of plants that I want to add to the tank. And of course, they're not going to be real because the Oscars will rip them out. The red-tailed catfish might rip them out.
Sorry, an earwig just crawled on my boob.
On your boob?
Yeah.
An earwig on your boob?
Yeah. He was trying to get free feels.
Got him.
It really upset me.
I don't even know the purpose of earwigs. Plus, Luke is absolutely sick and tired of looking at just fish. He wants something prettier to look at. So I'll make this agreement with you right now, brother. My son, I will make this agreement with you right now. I will rescape the tank for you, and I hope you like it. Do you agree? I agree. Let's do it. Downside is this wood weighs a lot of pounds. We're gonna have to go outside for a sec.
What?
We have to go outside for a sec.
Okay. I didn't know if you were telling me.
As I rebuild the pond, and I know it's getting, we're at dusk, I've pressure washed all of this Malaysian bogwood. And this is kind of the layout that I'm probably going to do, starting in the corner of the 2000. The entire layout is about 5 feet long. It's about, I would say, 3 feet wide, and it's approximately 2 feet tall. All of this is going to sink. Malaysian bogwood is arguably the most dense hardwood on the planet. A lot of the times you do not have to even attempt to sink it. Mind you, this is 6 different pieces of bogwood, but it's really, really heavy. I'm not sure how I'm going to get this not only in the tank, but go where I want it to go without me needing to get in the tank. Hope the Pleco got out of the way in time. We do have some tools. I might have to get in the tank. I might have to put all of the wood in the tank and then get in. I say, I want this to look good. I have some things I want to do. There are no stingrays in the tank right now, so I'll at least be able to do this properly. But let's just try it without. This wood snapped off when it went in the tank. That's fine. Kind of stick it to where it went. Yeah, see, that's not even that tall. Luke's already liking it. Let's get another piece. pressure washing it was a brilliant idea. Of course, I knocked off all of the like rotting pieces that were very soft, any sort of mud, bugs, etc.
I even looked to make sure I didn't trip, and I tripped anyway.
But the most beautiful part is the sinks immediately.
Yeah, that's a nice treat.
Huh?
That's a nice treat.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a nice treat.
I also kind of want to give the Oscars a little place to spawn, because I think they're starting to breed. Now with those two pieces kind of connected, I feel like if I place this one on the top, it will kind of bring them together, make it look like one piece. Ugh. You might be asking, why no substrate? This tank has a surface area of 70 square feet. I have absolutely this amount of interest in gravel vacuuming that much. One of the things I also need to do and want to do is make sure that the wood is not necessarily touching the back end of the tank. I want the fish to be able to freely kind of swim around it. And now, I don't know how I'm going to do this one, but I'm hoping I can just drop it in place. Obviously, getting in would be the better idea. So now I just took those two really big pieces, kind of made them look like one. This one needs to come out more. We also still need to add plants. Yeah, I like that. Yep. So the centerpiece is only 2 feet off the ground, which means I only have to reach in by 2 feet. I think that looks natural. Okay. And now for some much smaller pieces. I'm gonna show you something real quick.
Those are small?
These are, well, they would be considered small, yeah. So, very flat on the bottom. That would easily go in a 10-gallon tank. This one's also flat on the bottom. These are beautiful pieces. Mm-hmm. However, my goal here is to kind of make them look as if they're a part of what's already in the tank. So wish me luck with that one. I'm going to try this one first. And the goal is to make that long stick even longer. I'm going to have to come over there. Yeah, see? And since it's all the same color, it already looks like it's the same stick. Gotta move these rocks out of the way.
Beautiful.
How's that? Does that look good? Yeah. Okay, and then this one, I'm thinking should go more centered. I'm kind of trying to make it look like natural roots are coming out of the background. Go down, babe. This one's kind of cut off on both sides. So, yeah, I think I'm going to have to try to get a little more creative with this one. I'm going to chuck it in. And hopefully I can maybe Oh no! The stick that I used to do everything is gone. I have more sticks.
Ta-da!
How's that?
Mm-hmm. I like it.
And now the plants. I might have complained about adding in the wood. Of course it was heavy. It wasn't easy. But that wood pile, with just my little gripper, is absolutely phenomenal. The next step is, of course, adding in the plants, and then we got to do rocks. Fake plants, they're silk. They stand about 6 feet tall. Well.
Yeah.
Right six, around there.
6 feet exactly, I would think.
Yeah. But my goal is to wrap it around some sort of wood like that. So that, and they'll float. They're silk. They'll float. Maybe something like that. Now, mind you, what does this remind you of?
Pothos.
Pothos, yeah.
I almost said plecos.
Plecos. But I think we can do it. So what I will do is try to wrap it around. Arms. It won't be easy. It's not going to be easy at all. I might have to get in. It just bundles up.
Oh no.
And Twitch is going crazy right now.
The Oscars are stealing the show.
What?
The Oscars are stealing the show. Gosh, they look beautiful though.
Yeah, see what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
So a few weeks later, and I'm not completely sold on it. I ended up adding the plants, putting rocks around it. I think one of the things I might actually do is take the plants out and then pile all the rocks behind or like jumbled in the back. Maybe in the coming days, I'm not entirely sure. What I will say is the arowana is completely fine. As long as things are like short to the ground and he can get around it if he ever chooses to, which he never really goes back there, he's going to be entirely fine. Before, we did have really tall wood and it did cause issues with past Asian arowana, but I'm not completely sold on the plants anymore. And that's one of the things that happens. Like, you can have a game plan going in, lay out your scape, and then sometimes it just doesn't work out. But I'm going to give this a few more days, maybe even a week, and I might make some adjustments. I won't bore you with another long video like this of me doing that, but I thought you might enjoy seeing kind of like how long it takes and what I actually am doing when I kind of make these little adjustments and whatnot. But I do think I wanted to get your guys' opinions, see what you guys thought on it. Let me know in the comment section below. I'll see you guys in the next video.